Girl, bring it back. Hey girl, bring it back.
How much you like it? 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 What's up, Roachy Squad? It's your girl Queen Bee in the cut once again, back with another video. I'm in the back of the Uber right now, rushing to the airport, y'all. I don't know why I always do this to myself. I always like procrastinate, or I get like, I don't even think I procrastinate. I just get ready so slow. I move so slow at everything that I do. And here I am again, trying not to miss another flight because I missed my last flight and I have to go perform in New York for this Laura Styles women's empowerment program thing. And I'm supposed to be getting there right before I perform. I was supposed to be makeup ready and everything. And here I am once again, just in the Uber. Probably gonna miss it. Hopefully I don't though. It's raining outside, y'all. As y'all can see, the traffic is a little bad. We not like riding straight through, but just pray for me, y'all. My birthday just passed. I had a wonderful birthday. I'm pretty sure you all seen the video. I haven't been recording much for my channel or really the royal family. We've really been slacking really hard. It's because of regular business stuff. It ain't because we just want to slack. But it gets hard. Like I said, it gets hard. So I guess whenever I post a video, I post it. But yeah. I'm just vlogging. I just figured I'd vlog. Okay, y'all, so I ended up missing my flight. I knew I was gonna miss it, but I messed around and I paid $320 more to get on a flight to get there at the same time. And I don't regret it, y'all. I really don't regret it because Lee would have been really, really mad at me because this is the second time I've missed my flight. But I just take it as, you know, a consequence. I had to pay some more money, but it's cool because the show that I'm doing, I get paid for anyway. So, and I don't want to let everybody down neither because I'm supposed to perform. So only thing is I haven't done my makeup yet, but truthfully I don't even know if I'm gonna do my makeup because I don't know. I kind of like the bare face today. I kind of like the bare face. We got a Powerade in here, we got some peanut butter crackers, we got some combos and some gum because my breath probably gonna be stinking after I eat that peanut butter. I'm finally on my flight, y'all. Y'all cannot hear clear because they're in my headphones. But look how fine my nigga look. Look how fine he look. Blow me a kiss. The phone is freezing. Here at the venue with Lee. Poor baby, she getting sick. I'm about to perform these couple, it's only a couple songs, right?
Yeah, like two songs for the Laura Styles
event. Two songs for the Laura Styles event, y'all, and I'm bouncing, boo. Claire's not with me, by the way. Claire's at home. So I'm going back to Mama Sandra's house, gonna stay there. Tomorrow I'm flying to LA for the BET Soul Train Awards Cypher. Okay. Don't tell me I don't get to the bag, nigga. Oh, they coming through with my vanilla coke and my throat cold and my personal sour patches and my Reese's. Thank you.
No problem. Personal shopping.
He came through with a couple cokes. I'm about to try rap snacks for the first time. So hold on. Let me see what reaction I get to it. All right, y'all. So this is the Fetty Wap rap snack. All right. This is a Fetty Wap rap snack. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna eat one and see what happens. Yeah, baby. Oh my God. I'm turning to Fetty Wap. Yeah, baby. I'm like, hey, what's the pillow? Seen you pretty soon as you came in the door. Wow, that's what happened. Okay, we're gonna try a little Boosie.
It's a little Boosie up in here, baby. It's a little Boosie. I got my kids and my kids, kids and my kids, kids, kids.
Wow, so these rap snacks actually make you turn into rappers. That is nuts. Darn it, I wish I could have recorded, y'all, but I did, and I went out there and I performed too quick. But the crowd was feeling me, you know what I'm saying? The crowd always feeling me, you know what I'm saying? Hopefully I get some footage from you know, the internet. The internet posts everything. But we're about to go to
P-O-P-O.
P-O-P. Can you sing for me?
I can't sing.
Say P-O.
I can write checks.
Okay, say P-O.
I
feel that. Write me a check with some commas.
I got a check for you.
It's the next morning, y'all. And got my makeup off. And I'm just laying in this bed. Really, I'm supposed to be flying to LA to do the cypher for the BET Train Awards. And I know it's a really big opportunity for me, but I'm not feeling too well, and I'm also not feeling too well about the cypher, because the beat that was sent just don't seem like I could put medicine or karma to it. And the last thing I want to do is get up there and make myself look stupid, because I'm gonna really regret it. I'd rather not do it and wait till the opportunity come around again, then make myself look stupid. So I'm trying to call Lee, but this woman is not answering the phone. I don't know, she probably on a bunch of business calls like every day. And I really just don't want to take the flight to LA anymore. And I understand that, you know, it's last minute, but usually that's how I do stuff. Like, I be so last minute with stuff, and I know it ain't right, but I be changing my mind about stuff for good reasons. So we're gonna see if I'm still gonna be able to go. I mean, I'm still gonna go or not. But I really don't want to. Look at my nails too. Like, I could be using this day to get my nails done. I have a Tidal event, okay? I have to perform at Tidal in New York with Lil Wayne and Kodak Black and all these other huge people. And my nails not even done. So you mean to tell me I'ma go to LA today, do the cypher, catch a red eye, back to New York, get to New York at 8:00 in the morning? I ain't gonna have no time to do my nails, cause like, no. And then Jenny wanted to do my nails today since I'm in New York, so I really need to take this time to like pamper myself and stuff like that. But anywho, I just wanted to talk about how good my birthday went. And I know that y'all already seen the video, so y'all probably tired of hearing about it, but y'all just don't understand that that's the best birthday I ever had. And I am so grateful, and I'm so like blown away with how much effort Claire put into my birthday. And something that he made me like remember is chivalry. And I'm not used to chivalry. And that's the stuff that old school guys used to do back in the day. Gentleman, smooth. Like, he's so smooth with it. And he always say that, like, I'll leave that to him to talk about. I'm not going to go into that. But to grow up and have his mom raise him, he came out pretty well. I will be doing a boyfriend appreciation video to let y'all know just about Claire, a little bit more insight of things that people don't know about. He was gonna do one too for me, like vice versa, how he like really was like a true friend. He still is a true friend to me, and we really helped each other out a lot. It hasn't been nothing bad that's happened since I've met him. Nothing coming from him. Ain't nothing negative came from him. And he said the same thing with me. And Lee is calling me back. Let's see what she say. Lee.
Yeah. What's up?
Lee, I don't want to do the cypher. Can we please cancel it? I know that you irritated. I know I said I want to do it. Like,
we kind of like can't cancel it. We have to figure it out, queen.
Why?
We're gonna damage a lot of relationships.
So Leah's telling me that we can't cancel because this is the same lady that we canceled on before because I think I was sick or something like that. And if I don't do this, the whole lineup for the Soul Train Awards will be messed up. I don't want to do that, but it's like at the same time, I don't want to look stupid. So we're going to have to come to a medium. We're going to have to come to a medium. But she about to call me back on three-way with the girl. So we're going to figure it out. We're going to figure it out to where nobody be unhappy. Because like I said, I don't want to look stupid. But yeah, I got a boyfriend appreciation video coming soon. My birthday was just so beautiful. The horse and carriage was everything. And I sit and I'm looking at all my gifts. Like my bracelet, y'all. Like he got me an all diamond bracelet. And look at how it just glistened. I get in the shower with it, all this stuff. I can't really take it off because this is worth a lot of money. He spent a lot of money on me. He said he like blacked out in the store. Like going from store to store. Like I love it. And I love my necklace he got me. This was like the necklace that went to my ring that everybody was talking about. But I love my ring, so it's a little small diamond in the middle. But it's very, very like simple and pretty and it's meaningful. And also my ring. I love my ring as well. This is a rose gold ring, it has like a heart. I'm pretty sure everybody's seen it on social media. And in the middle right here, like I can't. There's a VVS in there too. And then I've been rocking my Gucci messenger bag that he gave me. And like y'all, I've been wearing that Supreme bag forever. Or I'll wear like the Balenciaga bag. And I love my Balenciaga bag. But it's just nice to have something new. Plus this is a lot, it has a lot more room. It's still small because I like little small stuff. I like big bags too, but like I don't wear them every day, so you know. But this is like just the right size to fit my camera in, to fit everything, like stuff I need. That's a, like I never had, you know what I'm saying, Gucci messenger, and it's so nice. Everything from the scarf, the perfumes, the outfits from Pink. I packed every one of my outfits from Pink and took them with me to New York. This is a perfect time to have like a bunch of sweatsuit outfits because I'm getting bigger and I want to be comfortable and still cute. And I look cute in every one of my outfits. And y'all, honestly, I'm not gonna hold y'all up. I don't really go in Pink and buy the stuff because I'd be like, okay, this is a little bit too expensive for some doggone leggings. I just go to Forever 21 or like, I'm still like that, y'all. Like it's so weird. I will spend money on other people, but I won't do it for myself. And that's one thing that I need to stop doing. I need to start treating myself. But I just be feeling like, ah, I could get away with this, I can get away with that. Like I'm not materialistic. So you know, he got me some materialistic stuff, but it had a meaning to it. So, and every gift was perfect. I appreciate every gift. It don't matter what nobody else said about whatever. It's not about what everybody else like. It's about what Queen likes. And I appreciated everything. And I genuinely love everything. You know how some people get a gift and they be like, oh, this is nice. But they really don't like it because they try to be nice to the person. No, that's not me. I really loved every single gift he got. And and I appreciate it. And now he's made it really hard for me to top his birthday because we'll be on tour December 8th, leaving from Canada, going back to the US. And I can't fly at this point. I can't fly because I'm be too big. So I got to figure out a way to maneuver this because we're going to be in a tour bus. Maybe I can ask a tour bus driver to stop somewhere in a different state or something. I just got to figure this out because ain't no way this nigga gonna turn up on me on my birthday and I can't turn up back on him. So, and then after that, I have the baby, my baby Renzo's birthday, because it's his actual birthday. I'm birthing him. Then after that, I got my baby CJ's birthday. So I got all these birthdays, you know what I'm saying, to worry about.
and I'm excited. But I'm gonna go ahead and end this vlog, and I hope you guys are happy with the fact that I even uploaded, because I barely upload now. But I love you guys so much, and thank y'all for being my supporters. Let me tell y'all, let me just say one more thing. Don't nobody turn up like Royalty Squad, I swear. Like, I go to like a show and it'd be like a bunch of other performers and stuff like that, and the crowds, they be nice and lit, but as soon as I come out there, you know it's Royalty Squad, and they be screaming, like they be really like supporting, going hard, going heavy. So I just appreciate my whole Royalty Squad, and I love every single one of you guys, and I wish I could meet all of y'all, but it's impossible. But I just want to say I appreciate y'all. Without y'all, a lot of this wouldn't happen. So, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. Love y'all.